वेलकम टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल एजुकेशन इन्फॉर्मेशन। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम पार्ट वन। इट इज़ वेरी यूजफुल फॉर योर अपकमिंग एग्जामिनेशन DFCCIL हु हैव अप्लाइड फॉर एग्जीक्यूटिव एंड फॉर जूनियर एग्जीक्यूटिव SNT। सो गाइस, दिस टॉपिक इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर एंड फ्रॉम टू टू सिक्स क्वेश्चन कम हियर फ्रॉम दिस सेक्शन। सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन। This is the part 1 and I will also make the part 2. So carefully you should have to be read, go through the all the questions, and I hope all important questions are important for your examination. So there here total number of questions is 38. So now start from question number 1. The first question is, for an ideal 3000 hertz channel SN ratio, signal to noise ratio. So question has been asked, what is SN? SN equal to signal to noise ratio. Now the formula is, calculate the SN ratio. SN equal to 2 to the power 2 FM / B minus 1. So here equal to FM equal to frequency modulation and B equal to bandwidth. Now we will put the data, 2 into 3000. What is 3000? This is the FM. This is FM, and now bandwidth is also the 3000. Bandwidth is also 3000. Now we will put the data, and so total number of SN ratio is comes 3. So option A is the correct option. Option A. Next question is, which of the following types of noise assumes greater importance at higher frequencies? So at high frequencies, time period of wave and transit time become comparable. So transit time noise is very important and it should be greater at high frequencies. So option A is the correct option. Now question number 3. In transistor radio receiver, the number of IF amplifier stages So correct option is option B, 2. So there are commonly 2 types of IF amplifier are commonly used. Next question is, to relay outdoor remotely located live programs, TV transmitter use. So in the TV towers or in the TV stations, the TV transmitter use always through the microwave links. So option A is the correct option. Microwave links are used to relay outdoor remotely located live programs in a TV transmitter. Next question is, it is found that in a telephone system, 60 subscribers initial calls during a 30 minute interval and the total duration of call is 100 minute, the load is. So the formula of calculation of load is, load equal to total duration of calls by time. So here total duration of calls has been given in the question, 100 minutes. So we will put the data here and we will calculate the load. So load is 3.33 eV. Next question is, if transmission bandwidth is doubled in FM, SNR ratio is, what is SNR ratio, signal to noise ratio? Now first we should have to go through this point 1 and point 2. SNR is directly proportional to square of the bandwidth, and now second is, SNR changes in the ratio of square of change in bandwidth. So when SNR is directly proportional to square of the bandwidth, that means the bandwidth will decreased 4 times. So bandwidth is decreased 4 times and SNR ratio is also decreased the 4 times. If transmission bandwidth is double in FM, so SNR decreased 4 times. So correct option is option C, decreased 4 times. Next question is, directivity means, here question has been asked, directivity means, in simple language you can say directivity means maximum directive gain. So option A is the correct option. Next question is, the power to the portable unit of a cordless telephone is provided by, The power of the portable unit of a cordless telephone is provided by, correct option is option C, rechargeable. You will see in the walkie-talkie, there are a charging system. A rechargeable cell has been inside and it has been charged through the charger. So correct option is option C. Next question is, computer communication networks have which type of configuration has been used in computer communication networks? This question has been asked. So we will see star configuration, tree configuration, loop or maze configuration. So all three are been used, has been used. So correct option is option D. Next question is, this question is assertion and reason. Now the assertion is, a balloon is an RF impedance matching transformer, and reason is sometimes a booster amplifier is used in a TV set. So first, statement 1 is correct or not, first we should have to verify. So balloon gives a 4:1 impedance transformation, it is correct. So a balloon in an RF impedance matching transformer, and reason is sometimes a booster amplifier is used with a TV set, it is also the correct, because in areas where TV reception is poor, booster is used to strengthen the TV signal. So correct option is option B. Both A and R are correct, but R is not the correct explanation of A. Hence here option B is the correct answer. Now next question is, in AFM system when the AF is 500 Hz and the AF voltage is 2.4 volt and the deviation is 4.8 kHz, if the AF voltage is low increased to 7.2 volt, the new deviation will be. Now, so the first we should not have to know the formula AF equal to KF dot delta M. Delta M equal to modulation, delta modulation. Now, we calculate the KF. So KF equal to delta F by delta M. We will put here 4. Delta, the value has been given 4.8 kilohertz. Delta F, frequency deviations. So 4.8 kilohertz we have put, and now delta M equal to 2.4 volt. So here we will put the value, and total delta F is come here 2. Now delta F dash is equal to 2 delta F dash. So 2 into 7.4, what is the increased voltage? 7.2. This is the delta M dash. Now 2 and delta M dash. So total value has been come 14.4 kilohertz. So now new frequency donation will be 14.4 kHz. So option C is the correct option. Next question is, the maximum range of a transmitter depends upon both its frequency and power. Both power and frequency determine the maximum range. Next question is, in a two stage cascade amplifier, each stage has a gain of 10 dB and noise figure of 10 dB, the overall noise factor is. So the formula to calculate overall noise figure, F0 equal to F1 plus F2 minus 1 divided by total number of gain. So in the question F1, F2 has been given and gain is also given. So gain equal to 10 and F1 plus F1 and F2 value will also be 10. So we will put the value total, and 10.9 value comes in the final end. So option D is the correct option. Next question is, fields are said to be circularly polarized if their magnitudes are. This is a very important question. Fields are said to be circularly polarized if their magnitude should be equal and phase angle will be plus or minus 90 degree. So option B is the correct option. Option B is the correct option. Equal, but they differ in phase by plus or minus 90 degree. Now next question is, three analog signals Three analog signals having bandwidth 1200 Hz, 600 Hz and third one is 600 Hz are sampled at their Nyquist rate. Encoded with 12 bit words and time division multiplex. The bit rate for the multiplex signal is. So correct option is option C, 15.6 kbps. So how 15.6 kbps? The total message bandwidth is, we will all three bandwidths, 1200 plus 600 plus 600 equal to 2400 Hz. Now sampling frequency will be 4800 samples per second. How 2 FM. 2 into 24. 2400. Now total equal to 4800. Now bit rate equal to 4800 into 12. Why 12? Because in the question given 12 bit words. Now after calculation, total comes 57.6 kbps. So correct option is option C. Next question is, in a CD player, the speed of CD is. Speed of CD is. So correct option is option C, varies from 200 to 500 RPM. Varies from 200 to 500 RPM. Since the circumference of outer tracks is more than that of tracks near the center, the speed of the disc is varied from 200 to 500 RPM. Now, next question is, the output resistance of a microphone is 20 ohm. 20 ohm, it is fed to a line of impedance 320 ohms to ensure maximum power transfer. The turn ratio of a transformer is. This question is very important and comes in every examinations of the technical papers in the communication systems. Now, how we'll calculate? The formula is turn ratio equal to square root of source resistance by load resistance. So here in the question given 320 ohm, it is a line impedance, that is line impedance is equal to source resistance. So 320 is here given, and now load resistance is 20 ohm. We will put the data and total values come here to square root of 16 equal to 4. So correct option is option D, 4. Next question is, in the absence of noise, if C is channel capacity in bits per second and delta F is channel bandwidth in Hertz and N is the number of coding levels, then according to the Hartley law, C equal to 2 delta F log 2 N. So option C is the correct option. So this is the law. You should not need remember this law, and this question all calculated. Next question is, audio amplifier needs both bass and treble control. Bass means low frequency tones and treble means high frequency tones. So audio amplifier needs both bass and treble control. Next question is, the open loop gain of an amplifier is 200 if negative feedback with beta equal to 0.2 is used. The closed loop gain will be in the question, in case of closed loop gain, the formula is GV equal to G by 1 plus beta G, where G equal to open loop gain. Now we will put all the value here. Gain is given by 200. So put the data in the formula and we will calculate 4.878. So option C is the correct answer, 4.878. So closed loop gain will be 4.878. Next question is, in a TV studio, the function of a vision switcher is to. In a TV studio, the function of a vision switcher is to edit television programs. Wisconsin switcher has a provision to select any one or more of a large number of inputs and switching then on to outgoing circuits. Next question is, why signal has maximum percentage of? So correct option is option C, green color. So this is the formula, y equal to 0.6 3 are 0.59 g and 0.11 b. So here we will see the question has been asked of in the way which has the largest value. So we will here we will see 0.59 g. So the value of g is, that is g matlab green color, the value of g is greater. So y signal has a maximum percentage of green color. Next question is, to ensure good transient response in audio system, the natural frequencies should be above 15 kilohertz. Why? The useful audio range is 40 hertz to 15 kilohertz. Therefore, natural frequency should be outside this range. So, in the given option, above 15 kilohertz, the natural frequency should be transient response in audio system. Next question is, if K is dielectric constant of a medium, the velocity factor in that medium is, first we will calculate actual velocity equal to 3 into 10 to the power 8 by root under K. What is K? Dielectric constant. Now after calculation of actual velocity, we will find out the velocity factor. So formula of velocity factor is actual velocity by 3 into 10 to the power 8. And when we will put the data here, 3 into 10 to the power by root under K. So after calculation, you will find 1 by root under K. So correct option is option B, 1 by root under K. Next question is, the total number of channels allocated for cellular telephone is, so correct option is option A, 666. Cellular telephones has been given assigned 666 channels, 826 to 845 megahertz and 870 to 890 megahertz. Each channel has width of 30 kilohertz. So correct option is option A, 666 channels allotted for cellular telephone. Next question is, the bandwidth of DSB surplus carrier modulation system, when the modulating frequency varies between 500 Hz and 5 kHz is, so correct option is option D, 9 kHz. So how FM equal to 5 kHz to 500 Hz, we will minus 500 Hz minus 5 kHz, so comes 4.5 kHz. Now calculate bandwidth equal to 2 fm. So 2 into 4.5 kHz, total equal to 9 kHz. So correct option is option D, 9 kHz. Next question is, the filter circuit for feeding a buffer has, the filter circuit for feeding of a buffer has, correct option is option A, an inductance in series and capacitance in parallel. How? Series inductance and shunt capacitance in a low pass circuit. So that's why option A is the correct. The receiver of a pulse radar can detect signal power in the order of, the receiver of a pulse radar can detect signal power in the order of option D, 10 to 12 volt, because it can detect very low power signal. It can detect very low power signal. When in a pulse radar, it detects very low power signal. So that's why 10 to 12 watt power signal has been retrieved. In a 100% amplitude modulated signal, the power in the upper sideband when carrier power is to be 100 watt and modulation system SSBSC is. So we will calculate modulation index. Modulation index is given by 100%, that is equal to 1, and PC equal to, what is PC? Power carrier. Now power in sideband equal to PC m square oblique by 4. We will put the data. Now total comes here to 25 watt. So correct option is option D, 25 watt. Next question is, if a sound wave has a frequency of 50 hertz, the wavelength is. If the sound wave has a frequency of 50 hertz, the wavelength is. Now the formula of delta, that is wavelength equal to V by F. So at room temperature, the velocity of sound in air is 330 meter per second. So it in place of V, we will put the data 330/50 hertz. Frequency has been given 50 hertz. So total after calculation is 6.6 meter. Correct answer. So correct option is B, 6.6 meter. Next question is, In a telephone system, the relation between load R, number of calls initiated during a specific interval lambda, and average duration of a call H is. So load equal to number of calls into duration of calls. So here putting the data equal to A. R equal to load equal to lambda equal to number of calls, and H equal to duration of calls. So correct option is option A. Next question is, the number of channel in a telephonic system is. So there are only two channels, left and right channels. So correct option is option C. There are two channels, left and right channels, in a telephonic system. Next question is, in a high speed modem, the data rate handle is about. When data rate in the range of 2400 to about 10,800 bits per second, modem is designated as high speed. So check from the options. This option does not comes into the this range. This option comes in the range, and this option also does not comes in the range, and this option also does not come in the range. So correct option is option B, 5000 beat per second. Next question is, the first pulse in a TV remote control is option B, preliminary pulse. The first pulse is preliminary pulse followed by start pulse. Next question is, in an FM signal with a deviation delta is passed through a mixer and has its frequency reduced 5-fold, the deviation in the output of the mixer is. So deviation depend on amplitude of signal, not on frequency. So the deviation will be the same. So correct option is option D, lambda. Next question is, this question is very important and comes also in the so many examinations. The modulation index is, if FM equal to 500 hertz and delta F equal to 2.25 kilohertz. So put into the formula. So delta F equal to 2.25 kilohertz and FM equal to 500 hertz. Now put the data into the formula, delta equal to delta F by FM. So delta F equal to 2.25 kilohertz and FM equal to 500 hertz. So delta F equal to 2.25 by 500. After calculation, 4.5 is the correct option. So option B is the correct option, 4.45. Next question is assertion and region question. Assertion is, an electronic tuner uses varector diode, and region is, the capacitance of varector diode depends on the magnitude of reverse bias. So a varector diode has a variable capacitance on reverse bias. It is a very convenient device for tuning. Yes, it is correct. So option A is correct, option B is correct, both are correct. So R is the correct explanation of R is the correct explanation of A. So correct option is option A. Next question is A plus 1.9 lens has a focal length of 25 mm. The diameter of lens is about. So F equal to focal length, D equal to diameter. Now put into the formula N equal to F oblique D. Now D equal to F by N. So put the data. F equal to 25, focal length equal to 25 mm. So put into the data, and now N equal to 1.9. Put into the formula 1.9. Now after calculation, it will become 13.1 mm. So approximate we will take is as 13. So the option A is the correct option. 30 mm. So the diameter of lens is about 30 mm. So these are the total 38 questions of the part 1 of the communication system. And now after part 1, next in the part 2, I will add another important question for the communication system. It will also for your upcoming all the technical papers exams. It is very important for you. So if you are new on our channel, please like, subscribe and share our content. Thank you everyone.